This is being shot several days later after the attack. You can see the damage much better. A huge bite on the tail. On the dorsal. And on the snout. Show us the snout, honey. Skin is falling off and new skin is starting to grow, hopefully in a few days. Well, today something happened out of the ordinary. The two Paroon shark catfish decided to attack the piraiba. They couldn't do too much damage to it, but I can see the bite marks. There's a bite mark right on the snout. There's a bite mark on the top fin. You can see the damaged tip of the fin. There's a bite mark on the tail. You see the rip in it and the tatter. They clamped up on the upper lobe of the tail. I was watching, when I first saw it, I didn't know who it was, but I was watching and I saw the Paroons showing a bit too much interest and coming down. They usually circle mid-water, top water, circle around the tank. But this time they come down and too close to piraiba every now and then. And then I saw one of them come over and try to bite the tail again, but piraiba wouldn't let it. Anyhow, this is unacceptable, but I have nowhere to separate them. It speaks volumes of the Paroons. I don't know why they do this. They shouldn't be hungry. Unless they're preparing to spawn or they feel like they need to bulk up because it's the season. So I'm not really sure why they would do that, but they have done it before enough times. As I said, they killed a large 2-foot Distichotus sexfasciatum, and they also attacked Indian shovelnose in this tank. Neither one of those they could eat by any stretch of imagination. They just kept biting them until those fish, in the case of Distichotus, perished. Or in case of the Indian shovelnose, I took it out and let it heal. Anyhow, as I said, I can't really separate them, unfortunately. So I'm gonna try and just take the Paroon's mind off of hunting piraiba or anything else by giving them a little bit of stress. I try to net them. They stress easy, so I think even just trying would could do the trick. I've done it before with other fish. to switch their attention from their prey or from their victim.
And it usually worked. Sometimes temporarily, and sometimes for a long time, and sometimes forever, never seeing any problems again from trying that, after having tried that. Then there are times, of course, when it didn't work. But right now I have no better ideas. I'm gonna try it. If I net one, I mean, it's gonna get real violent because they're very strong fish. Heavy, strong, fast, and they freak out like they have nuclear freakouts. So that can even hurt me. But I'm willing to try. See what happens. Since they're circling all the time, I hope it will be easier to catch one. See, they know already. They know something's up and they're not coming over. Good instinct. I need a net and a really long handle to reach for the back of this tank. This tank is 13 feet wide. And it's not easy to... It's not easy to reach for the back. I'm counting on when they get real stressed, they're gonna forget about their smart trick of hiding in the back and just swim all over the place, and then I can net them that way without getting into the tank. I really don't want to get into the tank. Try and nudge him with a long stick. Walls.
the way it's gonna go, I'm gonna have to get inside. Inside, it's not working.
Maybe this will suffice. We'll continue observing.